your TV,
and that fine DVD player.
Library freaks. I held a cat and I liked it. Its fur was soft like a woman. I held a cat in the shower. Then I French kissed when two men are in a situation like me and your father were for as long as we were, you take on certain responsibilities of the other. If it had been me, you would not made it. Major Kudu. We'll be talking right now to my son, Jim. But the way it turned out is, I'm talking to you. Look, I got this. This watch I got here was first purchased by your great-granddaddy in the First World War. It was bought in a little general store in Knoxville, Tennessee, made by the first company to make wristwatches. Up till then, he was just carrying pocket watches. It was bought by a private Doughboy E. Ryan Cooley. The day he set sail for Paris. This was your great granddaddy wore one. And he wore it every day he was in that war. When he had done his duty, he went home to your great grandmother, took off the watch, put in an old copycat, and in that can it seemed, till your grandfather, Dame Coolidge, was called upon by his country to fight the Germans once again. Your great granddaddy gave this to you. Gave this watch to your grandfather for good luck. Unfortunately for Dane, his luck wasn't as good as the old man's. Dane was a Marine, and he was killed. Along with the other Marines over the island, your granddaddy was faced to death. He knew it. None of those boys and any of the lieutenants would ever leave on that island alive. So, 3 days before the Japanese took the island, your grandfather, us together, an Air Force transport, a man he had never met before in his life, to deliver to his infant son, we had never seen in the flesh, his dad's gold watch. 3 days later, Dame Coolidge was dead, but when nobody kept his word, after the war was over, he paid a visit to your grandmother, delivering your infant father his dad's gold watch. This watch. This watch was on your daddy's wrist the day he was shot down over Hanoi. He was captured, put in a Vietnamese prison camp. He knew the Dukes ever saw the watch. It'd be confiscated, taken away. The way your daddy thought, this watch is your birthright. He'd be damned if he was ever going to let any of them look, put their greasy yellow hands on his boy's birthright. So, he hid the watch in the one place he knew he could hide something. His ass. 5 years your daddy wore this watch up his behind. Then he died of dysentery. He gave me the watch. And I hid this uncomfortable hunk of metal up my backside 2 years. And then, after 7 years, I was sent home to my family. And now, little man, I give the watch.
Thank you. Thank you. reason. Our story begins with early one morning, a dirty old man named Carson was seen riding across his town by his dirty son, Johnny. Little did Johnny know that his grandfather, the man you're knowing the most, has been a long night with women in tricky and wants to sleep.
Sounds like sexy Katie.
I don't think you can answer this question.
until I got three.